Amos.
Hi, Andy.
Well, where you heading for now, son?
Oh, I'm meeting the Kingfish over on Lenox. He's gonna snap some snapshots of me. You know how I'm always giving pictures of gals, and right now the demon.
$1,000 reward for information leading to the criminal's arrest.
Say here it happened about 2:30 in the afternoon. Something awful familiar about that picture. Holy mackerel!
George, what's the matter?
Me and Annie got a picture of the man that robbed it. Oh, boy. $1,000 reward.
George, what you talking about?
Honey, me and Andy were taking pictures over in front of Robinson's jewelry store yesterday about 2:30. And just as Andy was about to snap my picture, a fella ran out to the jewelry store right in front of the camera. And that was the crook. And me and Andy got his picture. And Andy has got the film in his pocket right now.
Oh, that's wonderful. That means $1,000 for Andy.
$1,000, and Andy got the film in his pocket.
Now, see here, George Stevens, you ain't figuring on getting that film away from Andy and getting the reward for yourself, is you?
Why, honey, what in the world would give you an idea like that? That boy just like a brother to me. Just like a brother.
Well, that's better. I better go in and get supper started.
And anyway, to get that film away from the boy, he'd have to be unconscious. Unconscious. Thank you, Lightning.
You are, Mr. Kingfish.
Oh, wait a minute. Lightning, what is you detouring around there, boy?
I just being careful. That thing liable to fall and knock somebody unconscious.
Yeah, I gotta get that fixed one of these days. Yeah. Lightning.
Yeah, Mr. Kingfish?
I'll get Andy over here right away. And incidentally, Lightning, run down to the drugstore and get some bandages, a bottle of witch hazel, and some iodine.
Thank you.
right on in.
Hi, Kingfish. Hey, what's the desk doing over there?
Well, I moved the desk over here so I could get a little more sunlight on it here.
Oh, yeah. Lightning said you wanted to see me about something.
Yeah, being you wasn't doing nothing, I thought you might want to engage in a friendly game of canasta.
Canasta?
Sit down, Andy.
Oh, yeah. I ain't never played no canasta, Kingfish. Is it hard to learn?
Well, it is from that angle. Move your chair.
Where must I put it?
Oh, any place. How about putting it on them chalk marks there?
Hey, what are them chalk marks doing on the floor there anyway, Kingfish?
Oh, that's left over from an old game of tic-tac-toe.
Yeah.
That's fine. Right on the left kick.
Something wrong, Kingfish?
Yeah, Andy, would you mind removing your derby there? One of the first rules of canasta is to play with your hat off.
Oh, yeah. Deal them on out there, Kingfish.
Well, now, Andy, as you is all set, I mean all set here, I'll get us a cold drink from the icebox in the back of the lodge hall.
Good.
And there, beloved brother Andy, I'm going to give you the honor of the first deal. Okay. Yes, sir, the honor of the first deal. Brother Andy, would you mind dealing just a wee bit to the left? Ah, that's a lovely dealing angle. Yeah, keep dealing.
Yeah.
Keep dealing.
I thought you went to get some cold drink.
So I did. I'll have to go out again.
Well, I'm still dealing the cards, yeah. How will I know when to stop?
Oh, you know all right, Andy. You know.
Something wrong, Kingfish?
Oh, no, there's nothing wrong. Mind your own business and keep dealing.
Well, I done run out of cards. Yeah, I'll have to get them drinks.
Oh, no, Brother Andy. You sit right there and relax. Sit right there. Oh. Yeah, I'll go get it.
Yeah. Kingfish, what is you peeping at?
Oh, never mind. Nothing ever works for me. Andy, will you please...
Kingfish. What do you do now, Lightning?
Andy, what are you doing standing there? You're supposed to be unconscious.
Now, take it easy, Kingfish. The plaster done fell out of the ceiling and hit you on the head.
Yes, and it's all your fault.
Oh, my fault. How did you figure that?
That plaster was supposed to hit you on the head. And by it not hitting you on the head, I got concussion of the brain. You in a jam, boy. Yes, sir. You are guilty of illegal substitution of the cranium.
Now, wait a minute, Kingfish.
Wait a minute, nothing. I'm suing you for
$500. $500? Where would I get $500?
From the $1,000 reward you're going to get for turning in the crook that robbed Robinson's jewelry store.
Kingfish, would you slow down just a little? I was doing too many things here that I don't know nothing about.
Andy, you remember when you were taking my picture in front of the jewelry store yesterday, and that fella running in front of the camera? He was robbing the store, and they're offering $1,000 reward for information leading to his arrest. And you got his picture right on that film.
Holy smokes, $1,000 reward.
Why, certainly, Andy. We had the picture developed, turned it over to the police, they catches the crook, they gives you the $1,000 reward, you give me $500, I settles my lawsuit, and you were $500 richer than you was when you got out of bed this morning. Come on, Andy. Lightning, clean up this mess here. Come on, Andy.
Think about this picture, Kingfish. After all, that crook,
Andy, nobody knows about this but me and you. All we gotta do is keep our mouth shut.
Yeah.
Oh,
Flower!
I'm so glad. run into you. Say, has you heard the news about Andy Brown?
Andy Brown?
Why, yes. He got a picture of the holdup man at Rob Robinson's jewelry store. And Andy Brown is in for $1,000 reward.
You don't say so.
And listen here, Clara. Don't breathe this to nobody.
Oh, why, of course not. Imagine that. Andy Brown's going to get $1,000 reward.
Well, that's quite an unexpected spitfall for the boy. What? Why, of course, I wouldn't dream of breathing a word about it to no one. I happen to know that that case is in the bag. A fellow lodge member of mine has a picture of the crook. He took it when he saw him come out of the jewelry store.
You don't mean it?
Oh, yes.
Frankie, open up. It's me, Pete. There's trouble, Frankie. Big trouble.
Take it easy, Pete. There ain't no trouble. We're lying low. We'll get rid of the jewelry tomorrow. We're in the clear.
Look, Frankie, a guy got your picture coming out of that jewelry store.
My picture? Where did you get this?
From a guy in the subway. They got your picture coming out of the jewelry store, Frankie. They got your picture.
Yeah. There was a guy standing in front of that jewelry store. A guy with a camera. Who is this guy that got that picture?
I don't know. All I know is somebody's got your picture. What are you going to do, Frankie?
I'm going to find the guy that's got that picture and cure him of a very nasty habit. Breathing. Well, Andy and the Kingfish started out to get that roll of film developed. First, they tried the drugstore around the corner from the lodge. Then they went a little further uptown. And then they went across town. And then they went downtown. And then they went back uptown again. And then the Kingfish decided to take matters in his own hands.
Say, Kingfish, I done found a druggist down the street.
We don't need no druggist, Andy. We're going to develop the film ourselves. I got all the dope right here on this book.
But, Kingfish, you don't know nothing about it.
Oh, Andy, pick up the stuff. Pick up the stuff, yeah.
All right.
And we're going to use the sky room in the basement for the dark room.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, going to do a good job on this here film, too. One of them regular good jobs. Come on, Andy.
But, Kingfish,
Oh, come on, son, come on. Careful there, son.
Don't worry about me.
Well, you didn't break nothing, you clumsy ox. Get up from there. There.
What's the matter now?
All of a sudden, my head feels awful damp. Wait a
minute. That sulfuric acid sure went to work on your head there, boy. You look like General Custer the day after. Use this room here for the dark room.
Hey, Kingfish. You sure you know what you're doing?
Why, certainly, Andy. All the directions is right here in this book.
Oh, yeah.
Step one, read directions carefully. You see there, Andy? The thing is a breeze.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Step two, assemble the... assemble the... Andy, I think the wind just changed on us. Did you familiarize yourself with that word?
It ain't parachute, is it, Kingfish? Maybe this book is for developing aerial pictures.
No, I don't think it's parachutes. I agree there's a para there, but there ain't no oot. And in order to have a parachute, you got to have a oot.
That's one of the paras, all right. Maybe it's paragoric.
No, there ain't no goric in there, neither. The thing to do is frenetic.
Oh, yeah.
Paraphernalia. That's the word, Andy. Paraphernalia.
Oh, boy, now we're getting someplace.
Yeah, certainly, Andy. Pass me the paraphernalia.
Oh, yeah. Which bottle is it?
The wind done changed on us again, son. We better get on to the next step.
Yeah.
Next step. In the absence of a developing light, the film must be developed in total darkness.
Yeah, well, read the next step.
Turn the light back on, Andy. It say here to turn out the light. But if we turn out the light, we can't read the directions. And if we can't read the directions, how are we going to develop the film?
Yeah. I wonder if MGM has this trouble.
Andy, I've got it. You stay in here with the light off, and I'll go out in the hall and call the directions through the door to you.
Yeah, yeah.
Andy, it's so simple. I don't see why we didn't think of it before.
Yeah, I guess we're as simple-minded as we should be.
Hey, you. Come here.
Okay, Andy?
Okay, Kingfish.
Turn out the light.
Turn out the light.
Get the developing tree.
Get the developing tree.
Unroll the film.
Unroll the film.
Prepare the acid bath.
Prepare the acid bath.
How is the acid?
A little on the bitter side.
Keep your mind on your business, stupid.
Be with you in a minute, mister.
Open development tank.
Open development tank.
The meter's right there behind the furnace. Pour acid in development tank.
Pour acid in development tank.
The meter is right there by the furnace.
I didn't come here to read no meter.
Excuse me, mister, for protruding. But your face look familiar. Ain't I seed? I'm afraid I has.
What'll I do now, Kingfish?
You developing something in there?
Oh, no, sir. We ain't developing nothing. That is especially no picture that we taken yesterday.
Now, look it, fella. I understand that someone over here in this large hall has a certain picture of me. Now, where is it?
Mister, I don't know nothing about no picture, who took no picture, or nothing about it.
Now, listen. Somebody over here snapped a picture of me, and I'm gonna fix him good.
Kingfish, why ain't you a... Well, I've been photographer Brown.
Oh, I didn't know you had company. Me and my friend here was developing a picture. You see, yesterday afternoon, we got a picture of the man that robbed the jewelry store. So when you catch the dirty crook, we gets $1,000 reward, and he gets 15 years in jail. You see,
You know, mister, you got the longest index finger I done ever seen. Kingfish, ain't this the man that was... Oh.
All right. I want that roll of film, and I want it now.
I'll get a man to fill him, Andy. We don't want no trouble.
Yes, sir.
I'll get it myself.
It's right there on the table, mister.
Hey, let me out!
But one thing to do, and that's take the film to the drugstore and have it developed as fast as they can.
Oh, me, my heart feels like it's coming through my coat.
Going someplace?
Kingfish.
Out of my way.
For my wife.
I'm looking for her, too.
closer. Come on, Andy. Let's get out of here. Keep crawling. Huh?
All right, come on out of there. Excuse me.
Nice day.
Beg your pardon.
He's coming this way.
We done give him the slip.
Yeah. But by the way, Andy, better let me have the film for safekeeping.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I thought I'd give it to you whilst we was running.
No, Andy, you had it. You done had it all the time. Must be in your pocket or someplace.
No, sir. It ain't here.
Andy, you mean to say that you done lost the thing?
I don't know what to think. I could have sworn I'd give it to you. Oh, me. Maybe it hopped out of my pocket whilst I was running.
Andy, you big dummy. You done lost that film. There goes our $1,000 reward. Get out of my sight before I lose my temper. You are the dumbest man that ever lived.
I'm sorry, Kingfish, but I couldn't help it. Maybe it's...
Out of my sight. I never want to see you again.
Oh, man.
Yeah, Calhoun, I really put one over on Andy. The poor dummy thinks that he lost his film.
Now, let me get this straight. Do you mean to say that you taking that down and getting the money for yourself?
That's right.
And is you trying to tell me that you're going to jip Andrew H. Brown, your lifelong friend, out of what is rightfully his?
Well, yeah.
And is you inferring that you wants me, Al Gunkwin J. Calhoun, to be a part of this low-down, underhanded scheme?
Yep.
Sounds like one of the best ideas you had in a long time.
Now, here's where you come in, Calhoun. I figured the safest way would be for you to take the film down to the police station and have them develop it.
You want me to take it down?
Of course. With that crook roaming the streets, I scared to stick my neck out the door. You'll take the thing down there for me, won't you, Calhoun?
Well, yeah, Kingfish, I'll take it down there.
I thought you would, because we are brothers in that great fraternity, the Mystic Knights of the Sea. And tell him the crook's picture, the last one on the film.
Okay, Kingfish. See you later, yeah? Come on, right. And the picture of the crook that held up Robinson's jewelry store is the last picture on that film.
Well, here you are, Sergeant. Just like the lawyer said, the last one on the film. And a perfect picture, too.
Let me have a printer as soon as you can get it. We shouldn't have any trouble picking up that guy.
Look, now we know you did the job. We got your picture coming out of the jewelry store.
Listen, fella, the smart thing for you to do is to come clean.
This is a terrible mistake. I ain't never robbed no jewelry store in my whole life.